no use remembering. Nothing's what she used to be.
You know how these telethons are. Tony was up for like 14 days and he was totally tweaked on Tommy's coffee, right? Drank too much of that Deadly Grounds coffee that he manufactured. He was wired, right? You know, just on coffee, you know. And he goes, fellas, what are you going to do? What song? I got to introduce you. You know, this thing is going national. I don't know if you saw this or not. And I said, we're going to do a solo, She's Got a Way All Her Own, which is the song that I wrote about Liza, the daughter formerly known as Liza, now known as Lola. What the fuck am I doing? I know that.
She said film directing, she didn't say what kind.
Oh! Oh! These thoughts haven't crossed my mind. Anyway, so Tony Orlando looks at the four smithereens, and we're just, the thing is a mess, you know. I'm ready to go on. And he says, so what are you going to play? And I said, well, we're going to do a song called She's Got a Way All Her Own. It's about kids, and it's a telethon, it's appropriate. And so he gets up in front of us, we're about to start, and he goes, and now those hit-making, that hit-making quartet from New Jersey, you know them, you love them, the Smithereens performing their big hit song, She Got Away. Did you see it?
I want the leather jacket.
She Got Away. Get the fuck out of here. Is there a difference between She's Got Away and She Got Away? Shayla makes a good point. I think we were playing some TV show. It could have been David Brenner's show, right? He was in the TV Guide. And we were lucky enough at the time, right out of the box, after being together for 6 years, just hit it with Blood and Roses and Behind the Wall of Sleep. And it was a new sound for the radio. So finally we had a chance to start doing TV, and our first national TV appearance is the David Brenner Show. I love you guys. I used to see you in clubs in the village. Yeah, get the fuck out of here. Right? We're really excited about it. So we pick up the TV Guide the day that we're due to appear on the show. And it said, from New Jersey, making their national television debut, hitmakers the Smithereens performing their songs, Bread and Roses.
And,
this is true. And Behind the Wall, Asleep. And I used to joke around, I used to paint houses just before we got the record deal. And I did such a shitty job, and mostly in Westfield and Cranford, New Jersey. The boss would come and he'd say, where's Pat? The co-workers would say, he's behind the wall, asleep. Anyway, here's the song I wrote about my daughter, Liza.
She protection, but you'll only see the part of her she wants you to see. Yes, you understand. If you knew her like I do, I'd just do what I can get to keep up on her points of view. And left to myself, when it's over my head, she's got the way of her own. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Sometimes she baffles and confounds me.
Oh yeah.
I'm fine when she wraps her arms around me. Song you wrote, Guns N' Roses. She goes, it's really great.
The important thing is she knew the name of the band. That's all that matters. Does she have spandex on?
Everybody did. Except for the Smithereens. We're the only like male band in America that didn't wear spandex. If you don't know that. Which is an award for that alone, right? You, lady, you. Oh, she let him look behind you.
Yeah, you wore turtlenecks, though.
How wonderful it is to be here by your side, to see you in the light, in your evening dress tonight. I've been thinking about you all day long.
Disaster movies. It's usually the first fucking building to go when the earthquake hits. And I always, my mother would yell to me from the TV room,
Patrick, Capitol Records is on. Hurry up.
And I'm running because as the building explodes, I imagine that the executives that fucked me in my career are flying out the window. Second album, Green Thoughts. And we were reviewing the album cover art, you know, which we kind of stole from different sources. But back then, there were no computers, so they had to do like color overlays. If they didn't get it right the first time, they had to send it back. It was a painstaking process, those of you who know art. But we hit it, we nailed it the very first time. So we're sitting in this lounge at Capitol Records where the Beach Boys recorded, where Frank Sinatra recorded. A lot of history. Every other day, Richard Carpenter from the Carpenters would come in and rent the studio out just to play piano. Because he liked the sound of it, you know? And we'd see all these people we admired walking around. So Dennis Dyken, our drummer, whom all of you know and love, he and I and Tommy Steele from Capitol. Tommy was the art director whose stepfather was Gavin McLeod. Loveville? And his aunt was Allison Hayes, best known as the 50-foot woman. Remember that movie, The Attack of the 50-foot Woman? We met everybody. Anybody of any importance we met.
Is he a minister now or something?
I don't know. So we're sitting there reviewing the album cover art. Tommy Steele, the art director for Capitol, me and Dennis. And in walks one of our heroes, Harry Belafonte, right? Look at Harry Belafonte in the flesh. He walks in, right? And there he is, larger than life. And, you know, this guy's iconic to us, you know, and that we grew up with, Dale. Jimmy used to do that on stage all the time. Daylight come long ago. So, anyway, Harry Belafonte walks in. He sees we're busy. He goes, I'm sorry, man. I don't mean to interrupt. I was like, no, man, come in, sit down, right? So he's kind of walking around. He doesn't want to bother us. I said, Harry, and I knew he was on Capitol EMI, the same label as we were, so he was in our business. And Harry's walking around this lounge that we're sitting in. And this is the very same lounge where Frank Sinatra romanced Ava Gardner. Yes. I mean, this is like, we were aware of this, being pop music historians. And we're sitting in there with Harry Belafonte. And he's just kind of moseying along. And I'm trying to engage him in polite conversation. I said, Harry, what are you doing, man? What are you up to? And he goes over to the garbage container like that gentleman just did before. Who was that guy? stand up and be counted, sir. He goes over to the garbage bin like you, and he starts looking through it. And he looks up at us. I said, what are you doing, Harry? He goes, like everybody else, I'm just looking for a hit. Come on, folks, think about it. It's a good fucking barn, right? Everybody's looking in the garbage for a hit record. That's how elusive they are. That's a great memory, isn't it? You don't get stories like this just anyway. Remember those Telly Savalas commercials for Players Club International? And you know what? It's bonus time, baby. You don't get deals like this just anywhere. Players Card International. Tell them Telly sent you. You hear that fucking stupid lollipop shot up his ass? Tell him Telly sent you. Don't fuck yourself. No offense, man. I hope people didn't know that. You ain't seeing that, right? So we'll do some songs from that session, right? funny things, you know. I remember the first tour, for especially for you, we traveled 15 months in a passenger van with the back taken out, the seats taken out of a U-Haul. And we took turns sleeping on a futon in the back. And this next song was written by Jimmy and I, totally fucked up, drunk out of our minds, on that futon, rolling around through Florida after playing the University of Florida Gainesville. Anybody attend that fine university? That was where that guy was going around cutting people's heads off. Remember that? Oh, what a great time. We went down there, and the first time we played it, there was a fucking serial killer on the loose. And he was literally cutting students' heads off. And he goes, don't worry about it. You don't have to lock the door. You're a savior. Get the fuck out of here.
Terrible. That woman serial killer down there, too. Diane.
Yeah, the one that I wrote Not Every Man. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That one.
I might do that for you.
All right.
Anyway, Jimmy and I, it's such a beautiful...
Yeah, I'll have my drink. You have yours.
It's like telling someone they're safe walking around in Canada without a bulletproof vest.
How do you know these things? You've never left the house.
From New Jersey, you hear these things. There's a reason I haven't left the house.
I understand.
But I thought your governor cleaned it all up. He's like God up here.
Who's that?
Christie. No. Maybe he's as big as one.
I heard he was a jerk.
He is a jerk.
Betty Babjack, Jimmy's, don't put this on YouTube or anything. But Betty went to school with him, law school with him. Jimmy's wife said it wasn't nice. Why would she lie? Fuck him, man! Fuck that dude! No, I don't know anything about him. I don't even vote, I'm apolitical. Anyway, we wrote this song. And it was really, everyone thought it was written for my fiance, Mary at the time, but I wrote it for my dog, Jack. Because I know we have some dog lovers here. And this song is called Especially For You. I've been running out of circles trying to find my way back to you. It's so long since we've felt this way. I forgot what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah.
that I'm happy to be inside of you. I'm young and I'm just trying to find